couldn't do boy, girl, boy, girl.
No.
Yeah.
But we should.
We should have.
All right, good afternoon, everyone. Nice to see you. I welcome my gentlemen composers. And
where are the ladies?
Yes, I don't know. Well, I'm sure that'll be one of the first questions. I thought since we have many new faces at this festival in terms of composers, I thought, would you mind just introducing yourself, maybe telling everyone where you're from, but for me, because if I could be something else, I would be a composer. Or if I could be a composer, I would be a composer. But I can't. And so I just want to know what age each of you knew you were going to be a composer, if you could pinpoint it. So, Matthew, why don't we start with you?
Hi, everybody. My name's Matthew Hindson. I'm from Australia. It's wonderful to be here. I'm sure you're here many, many, many times, because what a great town. I knew I wanted to become a composer when I was about 19. I actually had a job as a computer programmer in a steelworks. And I got this offer to go to university and study composition. And I thought, you only live once, so I've got to make a decision. Do I want money? Or do I want to create art? And so I decided to have a go and try to create art. And that was about 25 years ago.
Hi, I'm Lee Johnson. For me, growing up in Minnesota, the discovery of composition came about the time the movie Sting came out, when ragtime was rediscovered. And as a seventh grader, learning how to play maple leaf rag, I discovered that American music was something I'd never really heard before. And so from that point, in classical guitar and growing up in the orchestra, it was just kind of an uninterrupted and semi-natural progression to finding that creating sounds and working with the possibility of making them come to into reality was my life's complete fascination. So that's what brings me here today, and I'm glad to be here too.
Enrico.
Well, hi. My name is Enrico Chapela. I'm from Mexico.
Maybe pull the microphone, yeah.
And
Will you start again? Sorry. Do you mind?
Yeah, sure. My name is Enrico Chapela. I'm from Mexico. And, I started listening to orchestral music when I was a kid. My father used to like very much Beethoven and took me to the orchestra. So I dreamt of being a composer since I was a kid. My mother asked me which instrument I wanted to play. I immediately answered electric guitar, but she said, no, you know, you have to learn first acoustic guitar. So I said, no, I'm not interested. So I didn't learn anything until I could learn electric guitar at 15 years old. And so then I discovered I wanted to be a composer. Well, I confirmed my interest in composition at 15.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is Avner Dorman. I have to look at the sign to know my name. And I'm from Israel. I don't know when I decided to be a composer. I'm not sure I have. But every piece I finish, I tell my wife, this is the last one. So, but when I was a kid, when I was 9 years old, I was playing the cello. That was my first instrument, and I was pretty bad. You know, if anyone has like kids who play string instruments, it's very hard. But I had these two walkie-talkies, and I had a tape recorder, and my brother had a tape recorder, and we had a piano at home. And we sort of sat down and sort of recorded an album. I was like 9, he was probably 12 or 13. And everything he did came out to be songs. And everything I did, I listened to that tape many years later. I just had like these noises from the walkie-talkies, and I was playing one hand in 5/4 on the black keys, and the other hand was just banging on the white keys, and I was like screaming these weird things. And I just listened to it when I was probably 10 or 15 years later, and I was like, wow, this was must have been destiny.
I should just say that's not what his music sounds like at all.
No, not at all.
In case you're canceling out of the concert.
Oh yeah, sorry, anyway. No. It's very melodic today.
My name is Osvaldo Golijov. I'm from Argentina, but I live in Boston. My mother was a pianist. I am the oldest of four siblings, and so I guess until she gave up concertizing and started to teach, I spent a lot of time under the piano while she practiced. And I remember the memory that I think prompted me to be a composer is her doing a piece of Bach, the partita in B flat major, and like other music where you have the right hand playing the melody and the left hand playing the accompaniment, I saw that actually there were three different lines, that each of them was beautiful on its own and together even more beautiful, and they, you know, and I was fascinated by that, in the sense that other kids may be fascinated in this, like disassembling a radio or a clock or a watch. And I like to, I mean, so I studied the piano, but I always took off in different directions. I never finished actually playing any sonata, because always I went somewhere else. And yeah, I guess that from there I continued.
Hello, my name's Brett Dean. I'm also from Australia, and I also started my studies playing a string instrument, and that's how I sort of continued my studies very much as a performer. I play the viola, and we viola players are notoriously quite a slow bunch, and so it took me quite a while to discover my desire to be a composer, even though the process had fascinated me ever since I was young. And for some reason, I guess I was part of that time where a kind of creeping specialization had moved into the area of music, so that composers studied composition and performers studied performing, and never the twain shall meet. And I think that's a sort of tendency that's breaking down now. I think there are more performer composers, so I keep playing. But as I say, I was quite a late starter, really, and didn't really feel that I was a composer until a composer friend of mine in Australia, Richard Mills, sat me down after I'd written my first orchestral piece and said, "You are a composer now, take it seriously." And so I did, duly, at the age of, I think, 25 or so.
My name's David Heath, and I started off playing classical flute. And I wanted to be like Jimmy Galway, because that's what all flute players want to be like. And then I started listening to jazz, and I became completely obsessed with that. And then a friend of mine said, when I was about 20, said, "Look, would I write him a piece?" And so I just thought, well, why not, you know? And so I wrote a piece, and then all loads of people started playing it. And so I thought, well, why don't I write another one? And I've been on a kamikaze mission since then. And, that's really the story of how I got into it, and quite how I'm going to get out of it, I'm not sure.
Now you're stuck. Well, this is really an opportunity to let you ask questions of these wonderful composers, so I'll open the floor up to... Yes?
I would like to know how Dave composed the percussionist part in the piece last night.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm supposed to ask that you wait for the microphone before you ask your question, but I was very encouraging, so it's my fault.
How do you compose for the percussionist that we had last night? How do you compose that?
Is that for me or for Dave?
Oh, for Dave. Well, first.
No, it's just basically, don't tell anyone, but she was making some of it up herself. Okay. No, it's basically, I just said to her, look, because you can often, to really good musicians like that, you can just say, look, I want you to make an atmosphere like such and such. And they can do it. And sometimes it's best to say that than actually try and notate everything. So, for instance, there were just some lines there of, like, with a pencil. But I just said, look, that's just an idea. Just do your thing and just do what feels right. And so she did it. So I didn't really write all of that quite as it came out. But she made such a great job of it. I should just claim it, shouldn't I, really? Yeah.
Anybody else?
Oh,
quiet bunch. Yes. Oh, wait. I'm supposed to wait.
Hi, I'm a composer as well. It's an honor to hear your works. And this question is for Golijov. Please, I'm curious to know a bit about your compositional process with the Zul from a technical aspect, and also tools, whether you write it computer, piano, or...
Yeah, You know, what we heard yesterday is a heavily revised version of the piece. I wrote the piece, as I said yesterday, for Tanglewood, for an open space, and I wanted on purpose to do something very contemplative. And the piece was like that, and I found it really, really boring, like, seriously. And I think that the problem is, yes, I did want to avoid, the original version was for Yo-Yo Man. I wanted to avoid a virtuoso showcase. I wanted also to avoid a quote-unquote hero concerto. But in that first version, it was always in a state of bliss, almost like the beginning of the fourth movement, but forever. And I felt, you know, I think that for an Eastern composer, that, you know, for somebody from the Far East, that could be legitimate. But for somebody from the West like us, that we always strive for something, it's not